Deja vu is common within films, with producers borrowing plots, action sequences, and in some cases, footage from other movies to splice into their own. It's even more common when a film hits big with the mainstream and is subsequently mimicked to death. It's why we had that Hans Zimmer boom thing everywhere for a while. So therefore, it stands to reason that endings to movies will also be pinched every once in a while, and that's what this little list entails. Now, before we begin, I'm not saying that these endings are exactly the same, but that they do indeed borrow the same themes, angles, and in some places, imagery to such an extent that you can't help but see the tracing outlines of the flicks they're based on. With this in mind, I'm a very sick Jules for WhatCulture.com, and these are 8 movies you didn't realise stole their endings.
Hey guys, just before we start today's content, I just wanted to talk to you about our sponsors, Alliance Heroes of the Spire, the game with over 10,000 unique hero customization options. This is a game which will push your skills to the limit with real-time PvP, giant bosses, and massive guild battles, all on your mobile or tablet. You can click the link below, download the game, and you'll get a big boost with 50,000 gold and 50 gems to get you started in the right way. Enjoy, destroy, you're welcome. Now, on with the show.
Number 8. Alien 3 stole from Terminator 2. In an attempt to tie up the Alien story, which is already beginning to spill out of hand, Alien 3 tried its best to kill off Ripley and the Alien Queen that she was pregnant with. That was indeed the intention, but as we all know, the film was quite the sloppy mess. Especially the end, in which Ripley lobs herself sans mouth baby into a molten metal pit to stop an evil company using her for shady things. And if that sounds familiar, it's because Terminator 2 had pretty much the same ending, which had dropped just a year earlier. Arnie had a hot bath and rated the water level fine thanks to his thumbs up, in an effort to avoid being used by anyone with a mind to kickstart Skynet, which is uncannily similar now, isn't it? And we need to face facts that Alien 3 had a troubled production, some of which was presided over by James Cameron, who obviously had a lot of swing with Terminator. So therefore, the similar endings might be more than just a coincidence. Number 7. Trance stole from Inception. The general gist of Trance's incredibly convoluted ending is that Elizabeth has hypnotized Simon into stealing a painting for her, all the while bringing Frank along for the ride. The final moments see Frank given the option to forget the whole thing, with the film cutting out just before he makes his decision. Yet Inception did the same thing. The big reveal, the exploration of a sub-theme going on throughout the whole film, and the will-he-won't-he of Leo's spinning top. Now, true, one is about art and the other is about the reality of the world itself, but the concept is the same, and in many respects, Trance is the worst ending, because it feels so tacked on, whereas Inception heavily layered this idea of mind-bending from the very start. The obvious joke would be that this is a case of art thievery imitating life, so of course I'm gonna make it then. Number 6. Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull stole from the Raiders of the Lost Ark. Ignoring the fridge, the monkey swinging, the generic alien, the bad dialogue, the rubbish story, pretty much all of it, let's talk about the ending and the death of Cate Blanchett. She gets her head burned inside out after putting the crystal skull back on its body. It was a weird scene and kind of made no sense, but did display a power that was beyond comprehension, which is a good thing to do when talking about otherworldly beings. However, it felt all too familiar to fans of the series because it's kind of the same ending as Raiders of the Lost Ark. The big bad soy boys open the Ark and turn into a 10-year-old's plasticine art project as a result. The difference is that the Ark was clearly set out to be not looked into. The skull, on the other hand, well, that was just an alien skull, so had no rules whatsoever. It was just another throwback that unfortunately failed to land with impact. Number 5. The Machinist stole from Fight Club. The Machinist, otherwise known as Christian Bale Goes Horrendously Stick Thin Part 1, is the story of machine operator Trevor Resnick trying to figure out why some creepy guy called Ivan, who's following him around, actually wants. Resnick tracks Ivan's car registration only to discover that it's registered to him. Slowly it becomes clear that Ivan is actually in Trevor's mind, a form of his guilt for a previously committed hit and run. Yet you know what? It's impossible not to sit through The Machinist for the first time and not feel like you're watching Fight Club in some form. Both films end with the same imaginary friend reveal. Tyler Durden, the man who has liberated Edward Norton's narrator, is in fact a figment of his imagination, the expression of an ideal man devoid of all his faults. However, I just want to state that beyond this rug pull, they are totally different films, and each explore repression and mental confusion in very unique ways. Number 4. The Others stole from The Sixth Sense. After a traumatic hour and a half of Nicole Kidman and her kids hiding from rays of sunlight and the ghosts/not-ghosts in her house, it's finally revealed that they are, in fact, the ghosts, and people that were haunting them are actually beaming in from a real-world seance. It's a pretty great reveal and inverts everything about the movie on second viewing. Yet the idea of the mains being the dead dudes all along, of course, will remind you of The Sixth Sense. The setups are completely different, but the payoff is almost the same, as is the feeling of smug you will enjoy when watching this film through a second time and noticing all of the signals to the end result. Number 3. Transformers Age of Extinction stole from Prometheus. Normally, the ending of a Transformers film goes something like this. Boom, 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 blah, death, sunset, 360 shot. The fourth film mixed this up quite a bit. On top of all of the above, it added an extra scene that set up a sequel, with Optimus Prime jetting off into space to find his creator. But that's also the ending of Prometheus. While the film provided hints at the events leading into the original film, after spending much of its time in ambiguity, it ends rather openly with Shaw jetting off into space to, you guessed it, find her creator. Number 2. Toy Story 3 stole the moral from Toy Story 2. Toy Story 3 focuses on showing what happens to the gang when Andy finally gets too old for them. After a deadly run of misadventures and some tearful goodbyes, the gang are given away to a young girl, Bonnie. It's an emotional farewell to the characters as they accept their new life. Yet this moral about finding friends and the importance of trust is exactly the same as Toy Story 2. It's essentially a feature-length version of Jessie's song, a heartbreaking sequence where we learn about the cowboy doll being discarded and thrown away by her owner. Jessie's song wakens Woody up to the impermanence of his own existence. Yet through friendship, the toys make it through this low point towards the same conclusion. It's been done to make the franchise open-ended enough to keep adding the short stories and the now-confirmed Toy Story 4 into the mix. I'm not complaining, as both films are brilliant, but audiences might tire of this theme if it continues for long. And number 1, every Marvel Phase 2 movie stole their epic third act from The Avengers. So with the Avengers barreling towards their inevitably explosive end to the Infinity Stones arc, you'll notice that there are a ton of origin stories that have been woven together into one weighty narrative. Yet, as you might expect, if they're all moving towards the same end goal, then some of these events might start to feel familiar. And when you look at it, the endings of Iron Man 3, Thor 2, Captain America the Winter Soldier, and Guardians of the Galaxy, you'll suddenly realize that they're all kind of the same as the Battle of New York from the Avengers Assemble. Large armies, aerial combat, one character seemingly killed off, all of which sets a precedent for future Marvel films. Now, that's not to say that these films are bad in any way, except maybe Thor 2 and Iron Man 3 was just okay, but this familiar vibe is clearly being exploited to cater to what the fans want. Big battles, armies of drones, and fake outs for days. Not sure if it's a crime to steal from yourself, but that's totally what Marvel is doing.
Hey guys, thanks for making it to the end of the video. Aren't you a star? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe below. And also, there's probably more content flowing up above my head, so why not check that out as well? Could be a laugh. Probably. 6 out of 10.